Kids love to explore, but some children need help venturing. Jason Nolan, the director of Ryerson University's Edge Lab, helps to grant them that freedom. In his workshop in Toronto, he and his team of graduate students design and build objects out of cardboard that allow kids with special needs to play freely and independently.
What got me interested in this particular area of research, which I call adaptive design, happened by chance when I was actually traveling through Manhattan and saw a store that was actually I thought was selling these very interesting objects for children, and found out that they were very much adaptations for special needs. And I went in and met with the founder of the Adaptive Design Association in New York, and she explained to me what they were doing. And I immediately saw a need for this type of research up in Canada. Parents of children with special needs and hospitals and governments are all under financial stress right now. And the segment of the population I'm trying to work with is not those who are better served by medical or other institutions, but things that fall through the cracks, either needs or families or locations that just can't produce the type of things that children need. And our goal is actually to produce them very low cost, but also to teach communities how to make them themselves. So some of our objects, this is a rocker chair that's designed for children who need to move, can be produced for $3. It's ostensibly disposable, but it's beautiful. It was painted by one person, it was designed and put together by another person, and it can be customized for any other use. Here's an adult version of the same thing, or a large child's version. This can handle 300 or 400 pounds. But again, it is all made out of cardboard, and all this cardboard was recycled. Nothing we've made cost more than $5. Yet, to actually buy a medical device that would meet this type of need would cost hundreds, if not thousands, of dollars. Adaptive design is a model that sort of inverts the existing design paradigm. We're looking at the individual and what her needs are or his needs are at the moment, and we're saying, what do we need to change in their physical environment to help them accomplish what they want? The design that really clarified this for me was a woman who had lost the use of her hands, couldn't brush her teeth until they took the toothbrush and stuck it in a tennis ball. She can grab it and brush her teeth. Our model started very open-ended and grassroots, and our very first design was actually a chair to allow a child to play in a sandbox by themselves. And that chair has now been used over and over again in a variety of needs for a variety number of children, and we keep modifying it for each child for their specific needs. I see adaptive design as a social technology, largely, because it allows the child or the individual to act and interact with others without unnecessary support from an individual or a medical device.